on April 20th, 2010. The Deepwater Horizon rig exploded in the Gulf of Mexico, killing 11 workers and setting off the largest accidental marine oil spill in the history of the petroleum industry.
We haven't had an oil spill of this magnitude at this depth and in this environment.
This was a systematic failure on the part of BP, the industry in general, and of the government regulatory regime.
Over the course of nearly 3 months, roughly 4.9 million barrels of South Louisiana crude gushed out of the Macondo well and into the Gulf of Mexico.
It was beyond my worst fears. It was something I hope I never see again.
The Macondo wellhead was located at 5,000 feet beneath the water's surface, discharging large amounts of oil and gas under enormous pressure.
Most other spills are associated with a surface breach from a tanker. The oil sits on top of the water. This was a completely different situation. This was the first deep water blowout.
2.9 million gallons of the chemical dispersant Corexit were applied at the surface and near the wellhead to break up the oil and keep it from soiling sensitive marshes.
Dispersants were a novel concept in terms of using them subsurface. There's a great amount of angst, not only in the public, but among the federal agencies. What are the limits of this? Is this a good thing or a bad thing?
I don't think anybody knows what the answer to that is. I understand why the heads of agencies made the decision to use the Corexit. They were trying to avert a worsening condition on the seashore in the sensitive nursery areas and the estuaries. By making that decision, they made the conditions worse offshore and at depth. It was a no-win situation.
Trying to understand the balance of those pluses and minuses in the long term is clearly something that we have to find out.
Opinions on the fate of the oil vary widely. It is estimated that anywhere between 13 to 60% of the oil remains in the Gulf of Mexico, potentially affecting ecosystem health for years to come. What will the long-term impacts be? How long until the true extent of this disaster will be known?